Hello, Garrett here with boats.net, and today I'm going to show you how to rebuild the carburetor on a 78 Johnson 6 horsepower outboard engine. It's not too terrible of a procedure, just need to remove the cowling, pull off the carb, and rebuild it. It's that simple. So let me go over here, head over to the tool table, show you what kind of parts and tools we'll need for this job. The parts we'll be using in this video is a carburetor repair kit offered by Johnson. Comes with everything you need to rebuild the carburetor on your outboard engine. Make sure you check the link in the description below by clicking the little arrow beneath the window to get a link directly to the parts and special tools that we used in this particular video. Now, as far as the tools go, you're just going to need your standard run-of-the-mill toolkit, but there is one little kind of specialty tool that you're going to want to have, and it's an impact driver. Once you have your parts and tools in order, let's go over here and turn some wrenches. First thing we'll do is remove our upper cowling. That way we can have access to the carburetor. You can do that by just releasing this lever and lifting the cowling off. All right, next we'll remove our fuel line. All right, up next we're gonna remove our choke linkage. And that's just held in place with a little lock washer and a pin. So we're gonna use a little pick tool. Just very carefully pop that O-ring off. And then push our pin through. Now, our choke lever will simply pull right out. The next thing we need to do is remove our recoil starter. And we'll do that by removing 4 8-millimeter bolts. Now that we have all four bolts removed, we can go ahead and remove the assembly. We're not going to disconnect the rope portion of the assembly. We're just going to kind of leave it setting off to the side. That way it's out of the way. Don't forget to get your lower bracket for the recoil assembly out of the way. And we'll go ahead and remove this pin. Okay, now we'll remove our throttle linkage. It's in held in place with just one flathead bolt. As you're removing this, make sure you don't lose, there's a little washer on the carburetor side of this screw that you want to make sure you don't drop it down inside of the case. Pull the whole assembly off. Now that we have everything disconnected from the carburetor, it's time to remove it. It's held in place with two 12-millimeter bolts. Now, let's remove the carburetor. We're going to do that by pulling straight back on the carburetor, tilt it up, and just rotate it out. Just like that. Now that we have the carburetor in hand, let's take it down to the teardown bench, disassemble it, and see what kind of condition it's in. Before we open the carburetor up, we want to make sure that we clean the outside of the carburetor thoroughly. That way, when we do break it open, we don't have any possibility of debris getting on inside the carburetor. It's going to take some regular contact cleaner and just spray the outside of the carb. Take my nylon brush, just kind of work it around, knock off any loose bits of dirt and grime. Now that we have all the loose dirt knocked off of the carburetor, let's go ahead and remove the float bowl. Before we do that, make sure you have your little wooden block to set the carburetor on top of. Now, being that these are flathead bolts, sometimes they worry me on these outboard engines because a lot of times they can corrode and become seized in place. But I'm going to try a little trick I learned. It's called shocking the bolts. You do that by taking a flathead screwdriver and you put it on top of the bolt you're wanting to remove and you just hit it with a hammer. And we'll do that to all five of these bolts. Okay, If shocking the threads does not work for you, you may need to run to the store and pick up an impact driver. This is going to help you break those stubborn bolts free. Now, with the 5 bolts removed, we should be able to just pry the bowl straight off. Just like that. All right, now that we have the float bowl opened up, we can definitely tell this thing is in dire need of some tender love and care. I mean, this float is almost completely just disintegrated. You can actually see the old cork board that they used to use in the old float systems. So we're definitely gonna replace that with what came in our new kit. Okay, to remove our float, we're gonna need to remove this pin that holds it in place. We just need to take us a small punch and line it up with the pin and just gently tap it with our hammer to knock it through. And we'll just pull it the rest of the way through. And our float will lift straight out along with the seat. Now that we have the float removed, let's go ahead and pull off the old float bowl gasket. We will be replacing this as well. Now, let's remove our high-speed jet. Make sure you be extremely careful when unscrewing this because they are made of brass, and if you torque too much on them, it'll snap right off, and then you'll be back to square one. Now, let's remove our float seat. And once again, just as before, take caution when unscrewing this because it is brass. Now, with the major components out of the carburetor, let's go ahead and clean the inside of the carburetor. We'll be using a brass bristle brush to scrape out any of that debris. We just want to get this good and clean inside. Make sure you spray inside where the float seat is and the high-speed jet. We want that to just stay soak inside while we're cleaning the rest of everything up. And we'll do the same thing with the float bowl. We're at it, we'll go ahead and remove the drain bolt. Now, we'll take some compressed air and blow the parts off. Make sure you blow in each and every hole inside the carburetor. Now, let's remove the low speed needle and check what kind of condition it's in. Taking a look at this, we can obviously tell there's lots of pitting on the end. That is definitely not what we want. I went ahead and ordered a new low speed needle. If you line them up, you can tell that we almost have a quarter inch worth of material that's just gone. It's just eroded away. So we're definitely going to be replacing that. We'll go ahead and spray some contact cleaner inside the orifice and just let it set for a few minutes, and then we'll blow it out with air. Now, let's clean up the old high-speed needle. Okay. Now that we have both halves cleaned properly, we can go ahead and begin reassembling the carburetor. First step of putting everything back together is we're going to install the drain bolt that goes in the bottom of the drain bowl. And we'll make sure we'll use one of our new gaskets out of our kit. And we'll just thread it in. We're just going to tighten it down to where it's good and snug. Up next, we'll go ahead and insert our high-speed needle. You want to make sure you don't over-torque it. Just a little bit of torque is all you need. And we'll take our other gasket that came out of our kit and place it directly on top. Next, we'll install our float seat out of our brand new kit. Make sure we install our gasket. Thread it in place. And once again, you don't want to over-torque it. Just good and snug. Let's prepare our float valve, and we're gonna actually hook the little lever on inside of that cutout portion, and it'll click right in place, and that's how you want it to look. And we will slide it in place, just like that. We're gonna make sure that the valve sits inside of the seat, and slide it all the way down. And we'll take our new pin that came in our kit and slide it in place where we pulled the other one out. Lift it up a couple times, make sure everything's functioning properly. And it looks like it is. Now, we'll take our new float bowl gasket that came in our kit, set it in place, and our float bowl. Now we're just going to snug down all of our bolts. Now our last step is to put the low speed adjustment needle back in place. And just lightly thread it in and we'll run our nut back in place. Okay, now we got our carburetor all assembled. Now only thing that's left to do is install it back on the machine. Okay, before we install our rebuilt carburetor, we need to first remove this old gasket material on the side of the power head and replace it with a new gasket from our kit. Just using this, you want to be just gentle with the scraper. Just barely scrape off the old gasket material. We want to try not to gouge the mating surface. Now, we'll install our new gasket out of our kit. As we install the new carburetor, we want to take note that we make sure that the float bowl is facing down. That's the orientation we want to install the carburetor. We'll feed our low fuel mixture screw through the side of the cowling first and make sure the carburetor is facing down. And made it to the power head. Now, let's go ahead and mount it with the two retain bolts. As we go to tighten these up, we want to make sure we don't over tighten it. We just want these good and snug. All right, we've got our throttle linkage here. We want to make sure that we take that washer I told you about earlier and slide it on the opposite side. So you want it to look just like this. And we want to take our linkage, hook it into the arm, and then thread it in place. We're just going to move the throttle a few times to make sure everything's working properly. And everything is working just fine. Next, we'll take our choke linkage and reconnect it. So we'll grab our little pin and locking O-ring. Reconnecting this choke linkage can be tedious. The best thing I've found to do is just take your time and slow and steady on this one. Don't try to get overwhelmed with it because when that happens, you won't get anything done. So just take your time. Now, let's reconnect our fuel line. Next up, we'll take a zip tie to help us secure the fuel line. Okay, we've got our carburetor installed, our choke linkage in place, as well as our fuel line. All that's left to do now is reinstall that recoil starter. Okay, we've got the bottom plate here. This is what the recoil starter rests on. If you pay attention, you'll notice this little notch in the bottom of the plate. And if you look at the bottom of the recoil starter, there's an actual spring tip. You want to make sure that that hook sits inside of this channel, just like so. All right, now we're going to take our bottom plate. Look here, you can tell that there's a flat spot. That's where the dowel rests. We're going to make sure that portion of the plate is facing forward on the engine. Now we're going to just secure this with one bolt. We don't want to bolt this down flush just yet because if we do, we can't insert our spring. So I'm just going to thread the bolt in just enough to hold the bottom plate in place. With our rope still attached, next we just want to wrap the rope around the cylinder until we get as close to the case as we can. Now, we want to insert the spring into the lower plate. Now that we've got it inserted, we want to go ahead and tighten up our lower bolt again. This time, we're going to tighten it all the way down. Take our other bolt and tighten it down in place. Next, we'll take our dowel and insert it into the hole we pulled out from earlier, and lift up on the black plate. Then we'll line it up with the spline. All that's left to do now is install our two top bolts. Well, okay, that wraps this job up. Wasn't that tough. And it's gonna save you a ton of cash because you didn't have to drag it to a dealer. Listen, for parts and tools used in this project and more, come check us out at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, just drop them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Just want to say thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next video.